Hello! Welcome to another Andar's video game variety show. Or hour. You know, I try to keep it to an hour, but some of them have gone over. It doesn't matter. What does matter is video games. And today I'm going to play some, I don't know, comfort games is the theme here. Games that just bring me at ease. Or just, you know, for whatever reason. Maybe I just know them like the back of my hand, as I wrote in the description of this thing. Or they just have good memories associated with them. Or they're just damn good games. So, let's say we play one. I got four queued up here. The first one is gonna be a little game called Outrun for the Sega Master System. Note, I am not running this off of an actual Sega Master System, because hooking that up to an Elgato and then hooking up to the stream would probably take too long, and then I wouldn't feel like doing the stream anymore. But note, I do have the actual thing. For whatever that's worth, I don't know. Yeah, so we'll just switch over to that. Also notice, if you watch any of Jeff Hirschman's streams from GiantBomb.com, he uses this kind of same layout where he has the game over yonder, and then has like some box art here. What he does is he has like a slideshow going on, so it's like a whole bunch of different old video game box art. But I don't know, I always get kind of frustrated because I feel like it should be the game he's playing. That way, if it's some like random crazy thing that I know, then I know what's going on. So I will also say that my throat's feeling really scratchy. I feel dehydrated, and I have the best remedy for that, which is black coffee. Yeah, good. I'm the greatest. I should put on some glasses. Everything's all blurry. Ugh, these need to be cleaned. Whatever. Let's play some Outrun. I have to click on the actual thing first. There we go. This is running on the Fusion emulator, which is a, I guess, all-purpose Sega emulator for like a Sega CD, all the way on down to this here Sega Master System game. From what I understand, this was an arcade game, and maybe the Sega Master System isn't the best place to play it, but as a comfort game, this is the version that I've always played, and it just, it's in my memory because when I was a little tiny kid, and all the other kids had Xboxes and PlayStation 2s, I had this Sega Master System that my family, I guess, just had since whenever they came out in the late 80s. So, like, not only did I get a hand-me-down... I did not have a hand-me-down NES. I had a hand-me-down Sega Master System. And I had, like, six or so games for it. Outrun being one of them. I also had Rocky, which is a terrible game. There's actually an Angry Video Game Nerd episode about it. Which excited me at the time that came out, because, you know, when I was getting into video games, Angry Video Game Nerd actually taught me, I feel like, most of the stuff I know about old retro video games. And it delighted me that he was actually playing a game I had experience with. Whereas most other games, you know, I had not had any. I also had Choplifter, I think. And I had maybe my favorite game, which was Double Dragon on the Sega Master System, which is not a good way to play Double Dragon, but much like this probably isn't the best way to play Outrun. That's the version I played a lot, because that's the one I had, and also, I guess it has two-player, which the Nintendo Entertainment System one did not, which I think, you know, probably makes it better, because, you know, Double Dragon, double, like it's in the name, two dragons. You need two players. But I chose to play Outrun for this, the purposes of this stream, because Double Dragon is, like I said, a two-player game, as far as I'm concerned, and I do not have my brother here with me to play it. But anyway, we would just, you know, take turns seeing how far we could get in this game. Which, not far, because I forgot to switch into high gear. Yeah, I think, honestly, I was never very good at this game and continue to not be very good at it. And that's okay. So I think the farthest I've ever gotten is maybe the fourth string of roads here. You get to pick which soundtrack of three you want to go in with. You get Splash Wave, Passing Breeze, or my favorite, which is Magical Sound Shower. Yeah, I don't know. I would spend hours playing this game when, like, all my friends would be talking about Halo 2 at school. I'd be like, nah, man, Outrun. That's where it's at. Most of the time, though, we did end up playing Double Dragon instead of this, or Choplifter, I think. Although I don't have many memories of Choplifter. I do really remember that Rocky game, though, because we played that a lot, trying to see, like, it was one of those things where you're too young to know, like, if you're just bad at video games or if the game is bad, and as it turns out, that game is actually bad. So that made me feel better. But it would start off easy enough, like, the first person you fight would go down quick. And then you'd have this little training stage, and then you would fight someone who would just beat the hell out of you, and then you would lose, and then you try again, and the same thing would happen, rinse and repeat. I need to figure out how to do that S turn better. I need to slow it down. I feel like I almost could have gone through there, but... Oh no, two cars. Ugh. So I love this game also because you get that, like, choose your own route type thing. When you get to the end of a stretch of road, you get to choose, you know, on a Y, where you want to go. I could have gone to that place with the signs, but instead I chose this place with the rocks. which, you know, actually I feel like I prefer the place with the signs, because the way the rocks look, it looks like they're jutting over the road, which kind of freaks me out, even though, like, that's not how this game works. Like, it doesn't have collision like that. But at the same time, I love this thing because it looks way messed up. It, like, shows you that this is a 2D game and not a 3D game, because, I don't know, it looks like a slideshow at that point as you're passing under those, or you're supposed to be passing under them. It looks trippy. It's the best. Also, I feel like this emulator, I don't know, it doesn't sound right. I don't, maybe I'm wrong. I haven't played Outrun on the Master System in a while, but it just sounds off to me. I need to be in high gear. I'm gonna make the same mistake again. Don't hit the rocks. And we're turning. We're gonna hit the... Oh, no! We made it through. Probably still not enough, actual time. Yeah, we're not gonna make it. I don't know. Maybe we'll do one more. I'm gonna check real quick to make sure everything is streaming properly. It is! Look at that. I'll bring up the chat overlay if anyone does chat, although... I have to keep alt-tabbing out to check that kind of thing. Did not do as well the second time around, so let's see if we can fix that and do better this time. Let's listen to Splash Wave. But yeah, you know, what you see is what you get. As with most old games, this is kind of what it be, and what it do. You can switch into low and high gear by pressing up and down. And you have to outrun. What are you running from? Time! Because it's not an actual race. It's just, you know, get to the point. It is a game that is just a time trial. Man, I wish the whole game was just this huge road. And I still hit the cars even though I have all that space. I'm just bad at video games. That's how it's always been. But I bought Sega Master System nostalgically about a year ago to, you know, relive all those great memories. Played through Double Dragon with my brother again. Bought some games I never had for the Sega Master System when I was little, such as Phantasy Star, yes, the Final Fantasy one. And I thought I was buying Phantasy Zone, which was supposed to be like a cute shooter with some cool looking graphics, but I ended up buying like a Pac-Man ripoff version of that, so that was a bit disappointing. I still haven't actually played it. Also bought Alex Kidd, because like I guess that's the key Sega Master System, you know, mascot platformer before they had Sonic, so I felt somewhat obligated to give that a go. But yeah, Sega Master System, cool system. Vaguely fascist sounding name, but you know, what are you gonna do? This is the Master System. Anyway, but yeah, it's OutRun's cool because you take turns trying to see how far you guys can get. And so like when you have a house full of roommates. Like, I live with 5 other people right now. You know, you can have, like, an actual just, like, straight-up old video game OutRun party. And that's pretty cool. You know, playing this on an HD TV, maybe not the best. But hey. Oh, man, maybe we can do it. Come on. No, we cannot do it. Definitely not. All right. One more go. I'm trying to get more center here. Did do better that time. I really like Magical Sound Shower the most. It's the best track. Hopefully the sound and game, hopefully the mix, the audio mix is good, because that's usually been the thing that kills these streams that I do, is they just sound god-awful. Like, I think I did a game called OutDrive in the last Video Game Variety Hour, and it was just a train wreck when I got to that game. Couldn't hear anything. Posted it up anyway, just for, you know, posting stuff's sake. I don't know if that's a good way to go, but I don't really like to delete things or be like, no, this is, I'm embarrassed. And I am, but I don't know, I feel like that stuff is worth putting up there just to see, like, everything can go wrong. Maybe I'll hit it big. I won't, but maybe. And then people can look back on that. I'm like, oh man, this started out garbage and crap. My garbage and crap stuff, that's just how it starts. But, nah, there's no real excuse. Stuff should sound better. I tested audio for, like, an hour before this, so I don't know what else to do. Everything sounded good when I was testing it. Whoa. Thank you. Yeah, this will be the last one. I'm definitely not making it through. So congratulations if you wanted to watch some horrible OutRun gameplay. Some bad strats, unpro strats. That's what you got today. Oh my god. Wow. I don't even know where I went. Okay. I was so far out of bounds they had to put me back in. This is the worst run. The worst run. I can consistently get to the Y, but not enough time to actually reach the checkpoint. Man, it looks like I could have gone into the desert. And then I guess down there there's a city. Alright. Enough of that one. Let's load up something else. The next game, out of four. Let's do Fallout New Vegas. This game is just good. The best Fallout game. This is my character. Her name is Anna. She has poor eyesight and needs those glasses. This is Edie, a repair to them. This character loves energy weapons. And she is, you know, about this far into the story. She's hunting down the people who shot her, left her for dead out in the wastes. Level 7, I believe? Yeah. And playing on the survival mode. So, let's see. I think I'm out of ammo on pretty much everything. So, this weather 10mm pistol, and of course, my broad machete. I killed the Legion guys back in, I think it's Novak? Or is this Novak? No, this is Novak. I'm talking about in Nipton. That's the one. Because they burn that city to the ground, you walk through it, and then the guy with wolf heads is just like, hey, spread the news, Legion's here, we're doing damage. And then I did damage at him because, you know, you can't go into a town and just start crucifying people. That's not good. And they said, hey man, we agree. If you think so strongly about it, you know, do something. And then I did something. And then they're dead. So now, what I got going on is legionaries, when I was around this bend, sent some assassins after me. That drained a lot of my ammo. I went towards them and just made a very slow trek towards Novak. That's the adventure I got going on right now. So let's see what I can do here. I know that. Oh, hello, Victor.
Well, butter my butt and call me a biscuit if it ain't my old friend from Good Springs.
What are you doing in Novak, you silly Billy?
I just got the notion to make my way to New Vegas. Reckon I'll find out when I get there.
Oh, Victor, you're not suspicious at all. Quite a coincidence. Quite a coincidence. Quite a coincidence, meeting like this.
Seeing how this is the only road around, I'd be a sight more surprised if we didn't run into each other from time to time.
Good point. Just stay out of my way, robot. It's nice to see a friendly face
likewise,
around here.
Friend, likewise. Is any-
I don't know. I could use a bed and some medical supplies. I could use another gun at my side.
That's a mighty fine offer, but I'm gonna need to conserve my strength if I'm gonna make it all the way down.
We're heading in the same direction.
I'm sure you do just fine without a...
What do I get if I... use a bed and medical supplies?
New Vegas. I reckon you can find what you need.
Oh, yeah, he just tells me to get a room. Oh well, let's see here. Let's go see if we can get this quest started up, because I have to talk to the sniper and the dinosaur, I think.
God damn it. Don't sneak up on me like that. What do you want? Yeah, I guess maybe I am. But not like you. Huh. Maybe it should have been you I was expecting all along. Why are you here?
Speech 41. If you're looking for someone in particular, I could tip you off if I see him.
Yeah, well, you see anybody wearing Legion Crimson or a lot of sports equipment, you just let me know. You still have an answer.
A lot of sports equipment? Meet new people.
I think you bet. I don't have
friends here in Batman. I didn't say I wanted to be your friend.
No. No, you're not, are you? I need someone I can trust. I want you to find something out for me. I don't know if there's anything to find. My wife was taken from our home by Legion slavers once. They knew when to come, what route to take, and they only took Carla. My wife's dead. I want... bring him out in front of the nest here while I'm on duty. I'll give
you
an NCR beret to put on. It'll be our signal, so I know you're standing with him.
Oh, cool. I'll get an NCR beret.
Take care of the rest.
Forgot about that. Alright. Let's go get him on my party. I thought it just messed up there for a moment. Switch over that quest. That's Cass. That's not a... yeah, I guess that's not an actual quest on here. It's not miscellaneous, it's just the stuff. As it turns out, the leader of the hotel done did the thing. Activate this. Although, if I need to put anything anywhere in my very limited storage capacity, I'll just shove it into Edie there. Move. Oh,
good.
I have to actually accept.
No one in town knows.
Alright.
Yeah.
Should be in here. I'm not sure where. How do I wait? There we go. wait until morning. Let the AI do its routine. And I guess in keeping with the themes of comfort games, this is just a good game. I've been playing it lately just because, I don't know, Fallout 4 was a disappointment to me, and Fallout 3 I can't go back to after playing Fallout New Vegas. Let this fine town take care of you.
Well, he might have been wearing a fancy outfit. Had his nose stuck so high in the air you couldn't see it above the clouds.
City folk.
Those hoodlums he was with seemed to know Manny for some reason. Oh, what am I doing?
Isn't she the one?
Well, let's see. Dusty Mc...
Okay, I think to get the quest to actually proceed the story, I have to talk to the daytime shift sniper. How do I get them to follow me? Jingle, jingle, jingle. We, the representatives of the Council of Serum, have this day bargained and purchased the Jenny from Jenny. Yeah, that's her. How do I?
I hope you're finding it. I hope you're finding it.
Brings you here. Boom. They seem part of me. Huh? Oh, well, I'm Alice.
Dusty McBride.
Things treating you all right?
No.
We'd be grateful, especially if you find...
All right, I'd like to just finish this quest before I move on. Steal today's physician. What does the quest log actually say? Yeah, just send someone in front of the dinosaur, put on the beret to signal the... Let's see here. All this stuff is broken, jeez. Who are you? I'm already sneaking around with that gun.
Prim is a new sheriff.
Just random mercenary walking around. Seriously, what's your deal?
I hope you're finding.
I'm your host, Mr. New Vegas. And in case you're wondering,
how do I get them over there?
Whoops, better put on my newsman fedora here.
Maybe I just have to go tell him. Now that I'm hungry and thirsty. Oh, he's not gonna be up here. It's gonna be the daytime snack. Well, I can talk to him anyway.
What's going on, man? You talking about that chip? Well, listen, I can definitely help you find it. Maybe we can do a trade. You, Novak, it's home for me now. I want that to be for. But the only resource we got here is junk. Without that, people wouldn't. We get most of it up the road from the old rocket test site. I would.
Alright. That activates that quest. Can I... You're the person I sell the dinosaurs to, right?
Welcome to the Dino Bite gift shop. My name's Cliff. Bless her. Seems like every traveler I get it. They see the sign and think, gift shop? That's just too good to be true. Well, a friend of Genie's is a friend of mine. And my...
Cool. Still don't really know how to play a caravan. Maybe I have to wait till nighttime to actually get them to follow me. Which means we wait more hours. As we die of thirst and hunger. Let's fix that right now. Let's eat this caravan lunch. Drink this dirty water.
I hope you're.
Yeah, come with me. There's something you should see in front of the dinosaur. So easy. Coming? Come on, it's cool. Come on. Just the very vague cool thing. You're gonna love it. Look at this road. It's a cool bridge. Aww. Take those reading glasses. Alright, how'd I do, boss?
That's it, then. I guess I shouldn't be surprised. Here. This is... I don't know. I won't be staying. I know. Maybe I'll wander. You don't want to do it.
Intelligence 6. I thought snipers worked in teams.
Yeah. Working... But this isn't gonna... Fine.
Alright.
Let's go.
Cool. Now I have Edie and Boone. We're an unstoppable bunch of killing machines. And in this way, I can start making my way up. I should find someone to repair this armor. Let's see. Or buy some ammo. Yeah. I don't know, you get the idea. This is New Vegas. Most of you have probably played this game and know what it's like. Alright, that's enough of that. I'll save. I accomplished what I set out to do here. And we'll load up the next game. Which is, of course, going to be... I have to set up a resolution here. That's messed up. Grand Theft Auto, San Andreas, for the personal computer. I'm not very far in the game. Only played a mission, so I can actually just, you know, start it up. Comfort game in that I've played this game for hours, not the PC version. I played it a lot on the, you know, PlayStation 2 and Xbox, or the original. Because back to the Sega Master System talk, I eventually did get a PlayStation 2. So nothing's really unlocked at this point in the game, and I'm not really sure what the PC controls are. So far it's shift to jump, and like space to sprint, and then aim. You don't get auto aim because you have a mouse, so you should be able to aim properly. That's the idea anyway. And up here is this. Then I press tab to actually pick it up, and now I have more ammo. Yeah. Good. Anything on top of my house? I don't know. I don't think I've ever actually done that. Yeah, I'm up here now. Woo! Wild. Okay, there's stuff over here. Spray paint, kind of not. You can get spray paint inside your house, so you don't really need it here. Odd. Man, I want shift to be sprint and space to be jump. That would make sense to me. Let's do a mission with Ryder. As we reacquaint ourselves with Hood after having lived in Liberty City for so long. See you in my home. So with you. Yeah, homie, yeah, it's good to see you back. No homie love, no huh?
Man, what you strapped for? Man, some pizza place keeps paying over our hit up, man. Shit is beautiful. Teach on a lesson. The fucking Grove Street. Damn.
I'm always dead.
Let's go, bitch. Hey, show me how they drive on the East Coast, homie.
I like that this game kind of breaks the fourth wall a lot when it comes to CJ's driving. Hello. Howdy.
Are you doing a thing?
I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm doing a thing. It doesn't matter. Just maybe you probably don't want to change. Yeah, just that the constantly picking on CJ for driving ability, which is in reality just the player's driving ability. Or bringing up the fact that later on Ryder will say don't roll the car over and blow us all up in flames, and being one of Grand Theft Auto's characteristic most memorable feature. See, I don't have enough money for any of the better haircuts. Terrible. What does CJ look like with a beard? Terrible. All also terrible, even worse. I didn't mean to buy that, but whatever. I guess I didn't get anything. That works too. No, it actually doesn't work. I still have to get an actual haircut. I need to spend. What if I don't have the amount of money I need? Yeah, that's. Yep, that's the one I want. I know, he can grow hair. Great. It's unfortunate that, like in any... This is pretty much... No, I mean, they've always done this, but, like, the first few missions are always very boring tutorials in all the GTA games. They kind of stopped doing that, I'd say, maybe 5. They really get you into it a lot faster. CJ cares about his health. He's getting this salad. Never mind. Forget space is select and not enter. If you eat too much, you will puke. And CJ eats his meal at the counter.
Give up the money. This is a raid.
Ryder, not this again.
You ain't me, fool.
No one else is that small. I feel sorry for your dad. Shit, you crazy. Let's get up out of here.
Same old CJ. Buster. Straight buster. Oh, shit. Run.
He almost killed CJ. Kill him, take that shotgun. Okay, just trying to get my feel for driving again. Space is the handbrake. How do you... Okay, yeah, they still do drive-bys the same way. And my brother failed to close the door, so I'm gonna go do that. Back in the game. I guess I'll just take Sweet's car and drive around. There's not a whole lot to do at the beginning of the game. It doesn't really open up until after, like, the 6 missions. Radio X is the best radio station. That 90s alternative music. Has a Rage Against the Machine song on it. Okay, I deserve that. On the PS2 version, there would be a 2-player icon. Is that guy actually angry at me? Yeah, some road rage. What do you want to do? Get him! Not even my car messing it up. So yeah. Los Angeles. Maybe the only city I don't really care to ever go to, unless I would be going to E3. So I was very disappointed when in GTA 5 they made Los Angeles the only city you go to. And maybe that's kind of like, I don't really... Grand Theft Auto 5 is a great game, but like I dropped it faster than any other GTA game I'd ever played before that. Like, I beat the story and immediately stopped. Tried the multiplayer out for a while when it had just came out, and the multiplayer was terrible when it had just come out. But I don't know, I think about getting back into it every now and again. I'd have to buy it on the PC though, because I don't think I really care to play... I play consoles less and less, now that I have an actual... I've had a good PC for over a year now, and it's fantastic, let me tell you. Although, when it comes to older games, the ports are usually terrible. This is okay. You know, the controls are kind of weird, but this is the game. Running well. See, I believe there is still some stuff to do at the beginning of this game, if I can find it. How well I can remember all of this. Kind of far away from where I need to be, though. I need to get back to the downtown area. Maybe my favorite Grand Theft Auto soundtrack? Second only to GTA 4, probably. It's up in the air between those. Great songs. Yeah, I don't know. Like, this game... Yeah, I've spent countless hours in this game with doing stuff like the, gang territory missions, and... Just, there's a lot of content here, as I'm sure you know. Like, a surprising, like, unprecedented amount of content for, like, a PS2 game, or for, like, what Vice City and GTA 3 were. Like, GTA 3 and Vice City feel empty and barren, compared to this game. Which I wish I had, like, a later save to actually show all that off, but, I don't know. Again, this is a game you've probably played before, like, widely thought of as the best GTA game. And again, I'll probably actually side with, GTA 4 on that one, but use... Okay, return to use machine. I remember I actually spent a lot of time doing this. I don't know why. I'll, you know, place a bet on Crack Horse. No, I won't, because again, gotta press space for that. Let's do $100 on Crack Horse. Let's go. Place that bet. And I just watch. Come on, Crack Horse. My horse is named Bother? I thought I voted for Crack Horse. Looks like I'm about to win. Unless, no, Purple Horse is getting up in there. That's rough. Come on, Crack... Come on, Nay Bother. You can do it. Stay in the game. Yeah! Gambling! And that's how you get a whole bunch of money. So you got that from the start. You know, that's not super exciting. Actual, real gambling games open up once you get to Las Venturas. And if I can find a motorcycle, I can, you know, make that jump, of course. The classic tallest building in the game. Probably not worthwhile to wait for a motorcycle, but there's a parachute up here. How does the parachute work? I'd assume a space bar. We'll find out. Whee! Okay, no, it's clicking as if it were a weapon. And yeah, I would just spend hours doing this, you know? Like, not particularly exciting, but like, I don't know, this game just grabbed me when I was, I don't know, it was 2004. I was in elementary school playing this game. I remember I got it for Christmas. I was living with my aunt at the time, and my uncle bought it for me. And she didn't know he had bought it for me, and she seemed kinda like, you know, it was Christmas Day, so she had to pretend to be like, oh wow, cool, and then like after the fact very much of like, wow, I can't believe Santa would buy you that game. Are they about to play fucking music? Whatever. Living room roommates. Yeah, I guess that's my cue for I need to start moving on. Yeah. Alright. Let's get to our last game of the block here. Which will be one of the best games ever made. One of the best games ever made. That's better. Mass Effect. The first one. This is the... when I got an Xbox 360, I got two games for it. They were BioShock and Mass Effect. And that started a tradition, a personal one of me, that whenever I got a console, I would get two games for it. Because, you know. And I got these games because BioShock had won the Game of the Year. I had heard on the Spike TV Game Awards, when Spike still did the Game Awards, and BioShock had won, but Mass Effect had captured my interest, because they're like, you can make all these choices, and I don't know of any other games where I got to make choices and impact the story. That's crazy. And I would eventually, you know, get a bit older, dive into more video games, and find out that's not actually that unique. What's unique about this game was the dialogue wheel, I suppose, and the way it presented it to you, and the way your character had a voice and was actually, like, in the story and was a character. And you don't really make any choices. Like, it's all a big illusion. And they would... or like, your choices in this game will matter in Mass Effect 2. And they didn't really matter in Mass Effect 2. Like, someone would say, like, oh, hey, you made this choice, and it would show you that it was capable of doing that. But then you just threw it off, and like, okay, maybe it'll all come together in Mass Effect 3. And then it absolutely did not. It manifested itself in a war score, so... if you saved this person, you would get a little card that would give you like 20 war score or galactic readiness points. I'm like, okay, that's how the choices manifest in just like a raw number. That was disappointing. But on their own, every single Mass Effect game other than Mass Effect Andromeda is good. Mass Effect 2 is the best one, followed by Mass Effect 1 here. The most different of all the Mass Effect games, because it... is not, you know, it's a shooter, but it's definitely more of an RPG first. Mass Effect Andromeda, according to what they say, was trying to, like, be a sequel to this game more so than the other ones. And it just missed the mark in every single way. Because this game has a big variety of planets for you to go to. Whereas Mass Effect Andromeda only has 5. What is this? The MSV Worthington. And you just go out here, discover stuff. Like, there's this derelict spaceship over here. Of human design configured for mixed freight and passenger hauling, the ship appears to be shut down state. The main structures are cold, and it is adrift in the orbit. I'll board that and just, you know, go on cool sci-fi adventures with your space buddies. Some of the best writing in video games. My favorite combo is Erdnot, Rex, and Talizora Noraya. Well, she's not Voss Normandy yet. She will be in Mass Effect 2. When this actually becomes her home. Let's see, am I actually... I'll just auto-level up everyone else. Again, playing as a woman named Anna. And auto-level up. And we'll see what's going on here. Creepy space mystery.
Most of the systems are shut down. It's just running on basic life support.
And all these side quests, well, not all of them. Some of them are just go here, kill people, but like... There are a lot more side quests in this game that are interesting. And, you know, some of them are just like... sci-fi tropes and cliches, but like... still cool.
That was no accident.
Can I? Okay, I can press E for the actions. Have not played the save in a long time. No one here. Who are you?
That machine's keeping him alive.
I'm not seeing any brain activity on the readouts. He's dead. This body is just an empty shell.
There's no ghost in that shell.
Maybe we should shut the machine down. It's the merciful thing to do.
It's your decision.
Coffee's getting cold.
But maybe we should wait until we know more about what's going on before we do anything.
Leave on
it's
for now.
Thing,
what? Oh no! Okay. Still lets me come back. She just says that every single time.
Jacob's not going to make it. His brain was deprived of oxygen for too long. There's nothing any of us can do for him now except let him die.
It's weird, like, how much I remember of the side quests, because I know what's going to happen. I'm only going through all this stuff just to, I guess, show off the game, but, like, there are points in this game along the story path where I can just recite the dialogue. I played most of this game, of course, on the Xbox 360, so this is kind of my first playthrough on the PC. And I haven't gotten used to the hacking game. It's a lot, it's not on the 360, it's just a Simon Says. But this, you actually have to kind of like pay attention. It's more of a game. I guess I like this hacking game better, but the Xbox 360 one was so easy, and it was so fun to, you know, because it was easy. I don't know, it's also just a thing of, that's the one I'm used to, and so now there's this new thing, I'm just, I don't know how to feel about it. But I think overall, because there's more interaction, or there's more thought you have to put into it, probably actually a better system. And it's all meaningless, because you get Omni-Gel by breaking down, like, loot that's crappy and you don't want, and you can just slap Omni-Gel on it and move on. Like, yeah, 20 Omni-Gel, I don't even have to go through that. And it's really not that big of a deal, Omni-Gel is everywhere. Hacking is pretty trivial. Alright.
Jacob is showing no signs of brain activity. There's nothing more we can do for him. He wouldn't want to be kept alive by machines, so we're going to disconnect the life support. Dr. Smith is worried about Julia's reaction, though. She can't seem to let Jacob go. The stress is making her implants flare up, causing intense migraines. It'll probably be easier for everyone if we don't tell her until after we shut the life support down. give her a chance to... Julia, what are you doing here? Why are you...
Whoa! Alright. So there's Julia. She is a biotic. Luckily, we have powers that can deal with that. Damping. Temporarily disables. Is she targeting them, though? I can't tell. Okay, yeah. She's actually targeting them. Renile. Erdnot Rex. Let's see. That will, damages all nearby enemies and objects. It makes them more vulnerable to further damage. And I'll just sabotage her weapons so that her biotics are down. She's prone to more damage, and she can't fire on us. Honestly, because this is only one person, it's kind of overkill. But oh well.
You did the right thing, Shepard.
Night night. Then, okay, R is grenade, that's not what I want. I want to put my weapons away. Z. X. C. E? Q. Okay. It's Q, everybody. Yeah, just quick in and out. Little mission. I spent a long time as a kid, I remember looking at these spaceships and seeing they have windows on the underneath, on the floor, so you can just look at the emptiness you're standing over, and I thought, man, that's definitely going to be a thing that happens in the future when we have actual, if we make it that far, and actually have spacefaring, you know, passenger ships. They're definitely going to have that. Because that's just cool. I mean, they have that with some things. Like, I think there's a bridge in China that's just made of glass, and you walk over, and you can look down and see how far it is, as if you're just floating. Well, I suppose the glass would have to be kept pretty clean for you to, for the illusion to be effective. Sun's starting to get in. That looks terrible on the feed. Let's go to the Hawking Etta. Also, another thing, I like that it shows you the routes, because space travel in the Mass Effect universe is done with these Mass Effect relays, so you have to go point to point. And they show you that, like, you know, you can't just go straight to the Citadel, you have to follow the appropriate roads. And it's nice that it actually shows you that to actually get to the Hawking Etta, you have to go here, there, there, and then finally to there. I think that's a cool detail. Like, Mass Effect is just a game full of them throwing details and, you know, actually, like, putting the world into the gameplay in smart and interesting ways. That makes the Mass Effect universe the best video game world and universe. It feels like the most realized that a video game has ever, you know, accomplished is in the Mass Effect universe. We've got a mission for you. An Alliance officer named Major Kyle has set up a small compound in the Hawking Etta cluster. He's attracted a number of followers, mostly biotics. And there are a lot of story threads in this first Mass Effect that they don't really follow up on throughout the rest of the series. Like, in this game, the human and the rest of galactic society, the rest of the species of the galaxy, are kind of at odds because humanity is just this new face that is powerful and quickly gaining more and more power at just like an unprecedented rate. And everyone's kind of scared of them because I guess the last time that happened was the Krogan introduction to galactic society and how powerful they were and how they thought that they should have more than what they had, and they started a rebellion that, like, threatened galactic stability and caused a giant intergalactic war. And so when they look at humanity, and the first thing that humanity, like, the first introduction humanity has to the galactic community is a war with the Turians. The Turians, of course, who are the dominant military force in the galaxy. And humanity does well. Like, the Turians take the planet of Shang-Chi, you know, because the humans are caught off guard, and then the humans immediately take it back, pretty much. And so both sides are, like, shocked. The Turians are shocked, anyway, that humanity was able to do that at all. So yeah, humanity is a big deal. They finally managed the peace because that war was based on this misunderstanding. Humanity was just opening up mass relays, and that's frowned upon because that almost destroyed the galaxy once. Because, oh man, there's so much lore in this game that's interconnected. Like, there were the Rachni Wars that brought up the Krogan, that brought up the Krogan Rebellions, which created the mistrust between humans because... Okay, let me start over because it's great. So, galaxy is all nice and peaceful. And then they're exploring. And they open up mass relays left and right. Set destination. Once they open one up, though, it releases the Rachni. My mini-map is actually obscured right now by my mic. And the Rachni are a powerful alien race that start conquering the galaxy. And so to fight them back, they bring up the Krogan, which the Krogan are fearsome enough to be able to fight them, and civilized enough to actually be part of galactic society, despite the fact that they are warlike and destroyed their planet in nuclear winter. But, you know, whatever. And then the Krogan, feeling that they had saved the galaxy, are, in a way, owed the galaxy, and kind of demand more and more representation, and eventually, you know, start a rebellion to try and take it all on. Eventually, you know, the Salarians and Turians team up to neutralize the Krogans through the Genophage, which, you know, limits their birth rates, because there were a lot of Krogan, in addition to them being fearsome warriors. And everything's peaceful. And then the humanity shows up, is opening, you know, these mass relays left and right, fearful of opening up another Rachni invasion. The Turians come in with a military force, not knowing what's going on, shut down that operation and occupy a planet. Humans, thinking that aliens are invading and going to destroy all of humanity, reply with massive military force, take back the planet, shocking Turians because they, you know, they think they're unstoppable. How do I get out of this? Okay, Q. So yeah, everyone's stunned. They make peace very quickly because it's, you know, based on this misunderstanding, the Turians don't want humans opening up mass relays, but humans don't understand that, which is why they were doing it. So they make peace pretty easy.
I need to talk to the man in charge. It's important.
Father Kyle wants nothing more to do with the Alliance.
I want this to end peacefully.
Hopefully I have enough Paragon for this.
We won't let you take Father Kyle away.
But then humanity, as powerful as it is recognized as the power that it is, and humanity is ambitious, like we know that being, you know, existing in just a non-sci-fi way, humans typically have ambitions. And so they want more and more say in the political process, you know? And that starts sending up red flags with everyone else, because that's kind of how the Krogan were doing it. So no one trusts humanity. They're new, they're too powerful, and they're too ambitious. Shaking things up. And that all works because they have a history that leads up to that mistrust. So that is an example of how this world is connected and great and grandiose and works. But also, I got distracted because I was talking about like the story threads that the rest of the series doesn't really follow up on. But look at these biotics. Biotic cultist. You know? because humanity wants to be stronger, and they don't have access to biotic abilities at the start, so they do some crazy research to give humanity, you know, basically their force powers. That's not what I wanted to do. That's gonna set off some bad stuff. So where is... Yep. That was a mistake. But anyway, they have implants in these people to create biotic powers, but like it has serious health effects. You know, people are kind of going crazy and losing their minds. And I don't have any shield ability. So I need to retreat. So they never really follow up on the mistrust aspect of humanity. They never follow up on the fact that, like, I guess they kind of do with Jack, Subject Zero in Mass Effect 2. But I don't feel like they ever do the storyline justice of these biotics with mental and health problems as a result of government conspiracy and interference. Actually, I do have Medigel. I don't remember how to use it, though. E? Q? No, Q is to disarm. H. Can't do it from here. R is grenade, I keep doing that. I have my shields back up anyway. There's other stuff that they don't really follow up on too. I can't really think of it. Okay, we need something to happen here. Someone use throw on that. I'll use damping on that. And I'm dead. That's okay. I wasn't really putting my heart into that fight anyway. Not knowing how to use Medigel. Hopefully that doesn't take me back. Yeah, that takes me all the way back here. Now you get the idea of what Mass Effect is. I would go in there. You know, I drop into these planets. Most of them look like this. Some of them have grass, but they're mostly just kind of barren. Which is, you know, an early... kind of early 360 game, like you kind of forgive that a little bit. But yeah, it's just cool. This game's great. I would have, if I had not thrown that grenade, I would have walked in there, found Father Kyle, and negotiated their surrender because I have high Paragon stats. But I accidentally threw that grenade, and you know, things went south. They did not understand that the grenade throw was accidental. But yeah, and this is the only game that feels like you're actually exploring the galaxy. Because the other games, when you go to other planets and explore, they kind of just give you a linear shootout most of the time. And this is the only game that feels truly open. Other than Mass Effect Andromeda, but hey, we don't talk... Oh, hello. It's a Thresher Maw, for some reason. Just, you know, stumble across stuff like this. Whoa! Thank you. Now this thing's gonna get me. You can kinda just kinda stay around one of their up, because they'll only pop up in some set places. So you can just kind of circle around and keep them in one spot and just circle straight from. But anyway, yeah, I'll end the stream here. I don't feel like I did Mass Effect justice. Like, I talked about it a lot, about what this game is doing story-wise, but there's just so much more that could be said about Mass Effect. If you've never played Mass Effect, you really need to play Mass Effect, I guess is what I'm saying. All of them, except maybe Mass Effect Andromeda. And you know what? This game hasn't really aged the best, although I am enjoying the hell out of it right now. So you could just skip to Mass Effect 2, because that's the best one, but this game is so much unlike Mass Effect 2 and 3 that it is fantastic in its own right. That I don't really know of any game that is like this. That was weird. It messed up on my screen. But anyway, you get the idea. Mass Effect's great. Grand Theft Auto San Andreas is great. Fallout New Vegas was great. And so is OutDrive. Anyway, these are the games that bring comfort to me at ease. So, I'll exit this out. Exit game. Switch over to this poor, horrible webcam and say, thank you for watching. Bye.